Hi, children. Welcome. How did you like the Hullabalooers? Weren't they great? The Hullabalooers. Well, now we want to remind everyone why we're all here. This is a benefit so we can continue hullabalooing. Now let's go on to our next act, our tap virtuoso, who's tied his shoes on so tight he has to keep shaking them like that. So without any further ado, let's get him out here. Slap, shuffle, step. Slap. Wasn't that marvelous? And now, from south of the border, we have a real borderline case. That's right. That little bombshell, a cheetah, Mario, and friends.
Hola, welcome to the Angels of Light Cabaret, and I'd like you to meet my countrywomen and friends. Leticia? Leticia? Y Felicia?
Hola.
Now we have a surprise for you. Give it all you got, girls. Cuánto le gusta, le gusta, le gusta, le gusta, le gusta, le gusta, le gusta. Cuánto le gusta, le gusta, le gusta, le gusta, le gusta, le gusta. We gotta get going, and where are we going, and what are we going to do? We're on our way to somewhere, the three of us and you. What'll we see there? Who will be there? What'll be the big surprise? There may be caballeros with dark and flashing eyes. We're on our way. Pack up your pack. And if we stay, we won't come back. How can we go? We haven't got a dime, but we're going, and we're gonna have a happy time. Now someone said they just came back from somewhere and picked a few petunias on the road. They told me I was blind if I can't get there. If that's the case, that's our place, the place we are to go. We gotta get going, what are we going, and what are we going to do? We're on our way to somewhere, the three of us and you. Who will be there? What'll we see there? What'll be the big surprise? There may be caballeros with bright and flashing eyes. I'll take the train, you take the boat, we'll take the plane, you ride the goat. Oh, we don't care, we either walk or climb, but we're going, and we're gonna have a happy, 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 happy. Cuanto le gusta, le gusta, le gusta, le, yes, we're gonna have a happy time.
Mwah! Hola!
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mwah!
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Now in this day and age of nuclear terror and Holocaust, sometimes we think of something loving like somebody else. And then we want to know where do we think of them most? Is it in their feet? Is it in their hands? Is it in their legs? Is it in their lips? Or as our young friends here will tell us, is it in his kiss?
Is it in his eyes?
Oh no, he'll make
like a stretch from women behind bars. And now for a change of pace, a little food for thought.
Tonight's lecture is entitled, How to Derive the Maximum Enjoyment from Crackers. Speaking man to man, the most important element in deriving the maximum enjoyment from crackers is the choice of a companion to help you enjoy them. She must be someone you admire, a beautiful woman, elegant and accustomed to sophistication. In approaching the companion that is going to help you enjoy crackers, it is best not to tell her of your intentions. Let it be a surprise to her. Be charmingly mysterious. If she accepts your invitation, proceed in making the following arrangement. Reserve 2 hotel rooms for the same night in 2 different hotels. 1, a single room in a Skid Row flophouse, and the other, a suite of rooms in the finest hotel in town. If you do not own an expensive car, be sure that you have one at your disposal for this evening. On the day of the occasion, a few hours before you are to pick her up, purchase several heads of lettuce, romaine endive, fresh spinach, and several pounds of fresh ripe tomatoes, cucumber, celery, lettuce. In other words, whatever you would choose to make an attractive salad. Finally, you must also purchase 5 gallons each of the following dressings: Roquefort, French, Russian, Thousand Island, and vinegar and oil. Take these ingredients to the room at the Skid Row Hotel. Pull back the covers on the bed and take the salad and make a 4 or 5 inch layer on the bed. Toss it well with your hand. Pull the covers back over the bed and make sure that there is no salad lying about on the floor. When you have accomplished this, proceed to dress for the evening. Sure, and put the salad dressing in the closet. Dress as though you were a waiter or a wine captain in an expensive restaurant, but leave some doubt as to whether that is what your attire really suggests. The doubt is, of course, a personal matter. When you are dressed and all of the necessary arrangements have been made, proceed to pick up your date. When you call for her, create an air of wistful mystery. However, try not to make your mystery dark and ominous. Keep it light and taunting. If she asks you what is planned for the evening, it is very effective to look into her eyes, smile faintly, and then look away. Drive casually to the flophouse. Make interesting conversation, but keep her wondering, answering her questions with only, "You'll see." When you arrive at the flophouse, take her quickly to the room you have rented. Once inside the room, ask her this question: what salad dressing do you prefer? When she has told you, go into the bathroom and drape a small hand towel over your hand. A la fancy waiter. Return to the room and pull back the covers on the bed to display the crisp green salad. One of the high points of the evening is now at hand. You must coax her to lie down in the bed. She may possibly reject such a notion at first. She may even attempt to leave. Reason with her adroitly. One of the finest points of argument to convince her that it is all right is to say, "Salads are good for you." If she still is hesitant, you can even go so far as to chide her for not being venturesome. Whatever you do, get her in that bed. Get tough if you have to, but get her in that bed. After she is in the bed, go to the closet and take out the 5 gallons of her choice of dressing, and with great flair, pour it over her entire body. She will probably make some remarks like, "What is the meaning of this, you crazy son of a bitch? What is this ridiculous tableau?" Enjoy them When you have emptied the entire 5 gallons of dressing on her, snap your fingers and say, crackers. Begging her forgiveness, explain that you have forgotten the crackers. Tell her that you will have to run to the store and for her not to move a muscle. Race out of the flophouse, drive swiftly to a store and buy a box of crackers. Do not buy fancy crackers. Buy saltines. When you have purchased them, drive to the fine hotel in which you have rented a suite of rooms. Go directly up to your suite. Place the box of crackers on the nightstand by your bed. Turn off the light. Get into the bed and settle down. Nibble on the crackers one by one. You will derive the maximum enjoyment from
Hey, Groucho!
Yeah, Groucho!
This an audience or an oil painting?
Hey, Groucho!
Huh?
This audience is more plastic than the walls!
Hey, Groucho, give me that cigar, I'm lonely.
As plastered as the lady in the next story.
Bring you to the 67th presentation of the Academy Awards.
The nominees are Deborah Carr, Deborah Reynolds, and Deborah Bidwell. Come and get your award. And then the winner is Deborah. Deborah Reynolds Leary.
Thank you. someone to be gay with, to play with.
Thank you. Tape line for this next number. Oh, Sick Damone couldn't make it this week. Engagement in Tahoe.
Thank you. Thank you.